Oh, life on today. Isn't it the most wonderful thing you've ever seen in your entire life?
Wow! Cool! What is it?
I don't know, but I bet Scuttle will. Come on, I'll race you!
Stop!
Use a little black magic to help out a few merfolk, and this is the thanks I get! Well, now I guess it's just time to turn the tides on Triton. We just need to find his Achilles heel, a weakness that'll put a crack in his armor.
The king is terribly fond of his daughter.
Especially the youngest one with the beautiful voice.
But she missed the submission.
Apparently, Ariel takes a gift for granted. Just like her mother did. Woman doesn't know how precious her voice is until she's been silenced. You two find out what the girl really wants, then lure her here to my lair. I'll whip up a little spell to make her dreams come true. Once we have her trapped, Triton will rush to the rescue. And then, my dear.
Yes!
The Trident crown and throne will all be mine!
But who cares? No big deal. I want
question.
Ariel, what is all this?
Just a few knickknacks I collected, that's all.
Ariel, you ought to be ashamed of yourself! If your poor father knew about this place,
you're not gonna tell him, are you? Oh, please, Sebastian, he'd never understand.
Ariel, down here is your home. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they've got up there.
I think he's really...
Trust me, Crimson. When I come across the girl in my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
Hammer.
So that explains it. Just a minute there, Flounder.
Who?
You know Ariel as well as anybody. Who's the lucky merman?
Gee, I don't know. I didn't even know it was love until like the second chorus.
Sebastian, any ideas?
Well, I tried to stop her, sire, but she doesn't listen. I love her, Ariel. You've got to stay away from those humans. They're nothing but trouble.
What about humans? Sebastian, have you been keeping secrets from me? Where is that girl?
Let me see. What did Scuttle call this one? Was it a diddy-wumper? No, a thumb-doodle. Whatever it was, Prince Eric held it in his own strong, beautiful human hands.
Ariel! What is all this?
Daddy, they're my—
Human junk!
No, treasures!
Did you save a human from drowning?
He would have died.
That savage brute could have killed you. And it's my job to keep you safe from harm.
But he didn't frighten me. He made me feel wonderful, right?
Oh, no.
Besides, I'm not a child anymore.
No? Well, you're certainly acting like one.
It doesn't matter. You don't understand. I wish Mother were here.
Ariel, I miss your mother just as much as you do. But I'm still the king. And you are never going to the surface ever again. Am I clear? Sebastian?
She'll be all right, Sire. Just give her some time. I hate him.
Ariel, don't say that.
And some friend you turn out to be, spilling everything.
I couldn't help it. He had my claws in a clamp.
I don't need you. I don't need any of you. Go away.
Ariel, I said go away!
I don't belong here. If only I could be up there. Tell me. got to become human yourself.
Can you do that?
My dear, sweet child. That's what I live for.
To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself.
Oh, souls, with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty old king when they called me witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways. Repentance seen the light and made this witch true, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And to legally please the I used to tell the half of the miserable, lonely, and depressed father.
Thank you. don't tell me. It's your hairdo, right? You've been using the tickle hopper.
Nah. I can't quite put my foot on it right
She's
now.
She's got legs, you bird brain!
Ariel treated her voice to become human!
Nah, kid, not your beautiful pipes.
You see, not a sound. What would her father say?
I'll tell you what her father would say. He'd say he's going to kill himself a crowd. That's what he'd say.
Now she's got 3 days to make Prince Eric fall in love with her. And to prove it, he's gotta kiss her.
The prince? Well, I'll say.
Today, I'm thinking.
Why? Isn't that unusual?
That's an antique problem.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Yes, very amusing. Well, she certainly knows how to make you smile.
Well, come along, Grimsby. Let's leave the young ones alone for a while.
You should see the princess's Grimsby drag sit in her. So prim, so boring, but you. So, if you don't mind my asking, what was it, an accident when you were small? No, I'm sorry, forgive me. Who needs words anyway? A smile says just as much sometimes. You're nimble on your feet, aren't you? Well, dancing means small talk any day. It's the way your legs smile, or laugh, lets you say so many things. Of a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step is one step closer to saying what you feel.
Wins.
kind of pretty. Okay, Ariel.
Don't be a guppy!
see, Your Majesty. These two separate eagles came and took Ariel to Ursula. And she turned her voice for a pair of flags.
Ariel bartered away her voice to become human?
Yes, and now she's given up her very soul.
Oh, Ariel, what have you done? Come, we must save my daughter.
Say goodbye to your prince. You're mine now, mermaid. Get ready to spend the rest of your days as my slave.
Ursula.
King Triton. You were right on cue.
What have you done with my daughter?
Nothing. She's done it all to herself. Training her voice away, and for what? Human!
Husband!
Give her back to me!
Not on your life! It so happens that your daughter made a bargain.
No.
Swapped her voice to land a man up where it's dry. Is it binding? Goodness, yes! Unbreakable! Unless.
Unless.
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes! Perhaps we can arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Make this deal and set her free, or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone.
It's not my soul you're after. It's my power.
Now, which would you rather be? King of the sea? For a father to his little girl!
Ursula, the trident is a great response.
Nonsense, Triton! Hand it over! Finally, the oceans belong to me! And now you poor unfortunate soul! Time's up! You're through! While the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole, all the magic of the trident and the shell in my control! And now the dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shore! Now see for yourself how bad it feels!
You poor,
unfortunate son!
Somehow, in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you've grown up.
Aww.
You love him very much, don't you?
Oh!
loudly to